नमस्कार परमहंस परिपराजक आचार्य अष्टोत्तर सत समान भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णविंद की जय। नामाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तविंद की जय। श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गो गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरिवर्धन की जय। वृंदावन धाम की जय। नवद्वीप धाम की जय। गंगा माई की जय। यमुना माई की जय। तुलसी देवी की जय। भक्ति देवी की जय। सौवीद भक्तविंद की जय। ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असमय। ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असमय। ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असमय। थैंक यू वेरी मच।
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
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 Page 172, texts 3 and 4. Paprachcha,
paprachcha,
chemam,
chemam,
evartam,
evartam,
jan,
jan,
mam,
mam,
prichata,
prichata,
satama,
satama.
Krishna,
Krishna,
Anubhava,
Anubhava,
Shravane,
Shravane,
Shraddhano,
Shraddhano,
Mahamana,
Mahamana,
Sangstam,
Sangstam,
Vigyaya,
Vigyaya,
Sanyasya,
Sanyasya,
Karma,
Karma,
Trai,
Trai,
Vargikam,
Vargikam,
Cha,
Cha,
Jat,
Jat,
Vasudeve,
Vasudeve,
Bhagavati,
Bhagavati,
Atma,
Atma,
Bhavam,
Bhavam,
Dridam,
Dridam,
Gataha,
Gataha.
Paprachcha che mame vartam,
paprachcha che mame vartam,
janma mam prishchata sattama,
janma prishchata sattama,
Krishnanubhava shravane,
Krishnanubhava shravane,
Shraddhano mahamana,
Shraddhano mahamana,
Sangstang vigyaya sanyasya,
Sangstang vigyaya sanyasya,
Karmatray vargikam chayat,
Karmatray vargikam chayat,
Vasudeve bhagavati,
Vasudeve Bhagavati,
Atma Bhavam Dridam Gata,
Atma Bhavam Dridam Gata,
Paprachcha Chema Me Vartam,
Paprachcha Chema Me Vartam,
Janamam Prishchata Sattama,
Janamam Prishchata Sattama,
Krishna Nubhava Shravane,
Krishna Nubhava Shravane,
Shraddhano Mahamana,
Shraddhano Mahamana,
Sangstang Vigyaya Sanyasya,
Sangstang Vigyaya Sanyasya,
Karmatray Vargikam Chayat,
Karmatray Vargikam Chayat,
Vasudeve Bhagavati,
Vasudeve Bhagavati,
Atma Bhavam Dridam Gata,
Atma Bhavam Dridam Gata,
Paprachcha Chemam Evartam,
Paprachcha Chemam Evartam,
Janmam Prichchata Sattama,
Janmam Prichchata Sattama,
कृष्णानुभावश्रवणे
कृष्णानुभावश्रवणे
श्रद्धदानो महामना
श्रद्धदानो महामना
संस्थान विज्ञाय सन्न्यस्य
संस्थान विज्ञाय सन्न्यस्य
कर्मत्राय वर्गिकं च जत्
कर्मत्राय वर्गिकं च जत्
वासुदेवे
भगवती
आत्मभावं दृढं गतः
आत्मभावं दृढं गतः
नेक्स्ट
प्रपाश्चेममेवातम् जन्मां पृच्छत सत्तमा कृष्णानुभावश्रवणे सर्वदानो महामनः संस्थानविज्ञानसन्न्यस्य कर्मचारितं च जात् वासुदेवे भगवती आत्मभावं दृढं गतः प्रपश्चेमेवार्थम्
जन्मं पृच्छत सतमः
जन्मं पृच्छत सतमः
कृष्णानुभावश्रवणे
कृष्णानुभावश्रवणे
सद्दानो महामनः
सद्दानो महामनः
संस्थां विज्ञान सन्न्यस्य
संस्थां विज्ञाय सन्न्यस्य
कर्मत्राय वर्जिकं सञ्जात् वासुदेवे भगवती
वासुदेवे भगवती
आत्मभावं दृढं गतः
आत्मभावं दृढं गतः
कृष्णानुभावश्रवणे श्रद्धानो महामनः
श्रद्धानो महामनः
संस्थां विज्ञाय सन्न्यस्य
संस्थां विज्ञाय सन्न्यस्य कर्मत्रयवर्गिकं च जात्
वासुदेवे भगवती
वासुदेवे भगवती
आत्मभावं दृढं गतः
आत्मभावं दृढं गतः
प्रपश्चेममेवातम्
जन्मां पृच्छत सतमः
श्रद्धदानो
महामनः
संस्थां विज्ञाय सन्न्यस्य
संस्थां विज्ञाय सन्न्यस्य
कर्मत्राय वर्गिकं च यत्
कर्मत्राय वर्गिकं च यत्
वासुदेवे भगवती
वासुदेवे भगवती आत्मभावं दृढं गतः जन्मां पृच्छत सत्तमा
कृष्णानुभावश्रवणे
शरदानो महामनः
संस्थां विज्ञाय सन्न्यस्य कामचाय वर्गिकं च जात् वासुदेवे भगवती
वासुदेवे भगवती
आत्मभावं दृढं गतः
आत्मभावं दृढं गतः कृष्णानुभावश्रवणे श्रद्धदानो महामनः
संस्थां विज्ञाय सन्न्यस्य
Exactly like.
Artam.
Purpose.
Jat. That.
Mam.
Unto me.
Pichchata.
You are asking. Sattama.
All great sages.
Krishna.
Anubhava.
Wrapped in the thought of Krishna.
Shravane.
In hearing.
Shraddhadanaha.
Full of faith.
Mahamanaha.
Great soul.
Sangstang.
Death.
Vigyaya.
Being informed.
Sannyasya.
Renouncing.
Karma.
Fruitive activities.
Trivargikam.
Three principles of religion, economic development, and sense gratification.
Cha.
Also.
Jat.
What it may be.
Vasudeve.
Unto Lord Krishna.
Bhagavati.
The personality of Godhead. Atmabhavam.
Attraction of love.
Dridam.
Firmly fixed.
Gataha.
Achieved.
Translation. O great sages, the great soul Maharaj Parikit, constantly wrapped in the thoughts of Lord Krishna, knowing well of his imminent death, renounced all sorts of fruitive activities, namely acts of religion, economic development, and sense gratification, and thus fixed himself firmly in his natural love for Krishna, and asked exactly all these questions as you are asking me.
So, Krishnanubhava-sravane saddhadana-mahamana Vasudevi-bhagavati-atma-bhavam-dirangata Krishnanubhava-sravane. When we hear from right source, the natural result will be Krishna consciousness, Krishna anubhava, Krishna bhavanamrita, saddhadhana mahamana. One who hears with attention, with faith, mahamana, just like the great sages in Naimisharana, they did. Real purpose is Vasudevi Bhagavati. Atma Bhavang Dirangata. To increase our affection or love for Krishna. Vasudevi Bhagavati. वासुदेवी भगवती भक्ति योग प्रयोजिता जनयति आसु वैराग्यम। पर्पस संघर्ष रिनाउंस, पीपल कैनॉट रिनाउंस, दे आर वेरी मच अटैच्ड टू दिस मेटीरियल बॉडी एंड एनीथिंग इन रिलेशनशिप विद दिस बॉडी, बट द रियल पर्पस ऑफ ह्यूमन लाइफ इज टू बिकम रिनाउंस्ड नॉन मेटीरियल बॉडी, दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड। वैराग्यम, दिस इज कॉल्ड वैराग्यम और रिनाउंस, बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट दिस मेटीरियल बॉडी, देयरफॉर वी गेट इट लाइफ आफ्टर लाइफ। दिस विल कंटिन्यू सो लॉन्ग विल बी ओवर पावर्ड बाई मेटीरियल थॉट। Material thought means this fruitive activities. I shall work very hard and I shall get so much wealth. And for this purpose I can go to church and temple. If God gives me millions of dollars, then I am ready to go there. So real purpose is sense gratification. If I take to religious principles, then I will get more money without any hard work. And if I get more money, then I will be able to satisfy my senses. This is called dharmartha kama. And there is another stage, which is called moksha, liberation. So people are not interested for liberation. They want to become religious for material benefit. But that is not the real purpose of life. Material benefit you cannot get more than what you are destined to have. That is already fixed up. According to your body, you get the body, we get different types of body, and according to the body, our material sufferings and enjoyment are fixed up already. You cannot have more or less. Otherwise, you see one man is working so hard day and night and he could hardly maintain himself and his family. And another man is going to the market, sits down for 1 hour and earns $100,000 immediately. You can see, simply by touching the phone, he simply asks, what is the rate of this, what is the rate of that? And he makes one transaction and immediately he gets $1,000. And this man is working hard day and night, he could not get even 2 sufficient meals. So that means, according to the body, the material happiness, just like you are, you have got this American body, so automatically your country's facilities, you are more comfortable than other countries because you have no scarcity, enough production, everything is enough. So according to the body you are getting comforts of life. And in another country, deserted country, very hard living, cannot get nice foodstuff, only living on animals, that is also very rarely. So these are divine, just like in Greenland, it is filled up with ice, they cannot get any nice food, still they live there. This is Maya. They not think, here the life is very difficult, let me go away from here, let me go to some other better place. No, he will not go. Janani janma mamischa sargadapi gariyasi. Our birthplace, even it is hell, it is better than heaven. That is Maya. Just like hog. Hog is living most of our minimal condition of life, with stools and filthy water, but still he is thinking he is living in heaven. Janani janma bhumishta sargada pigariyas. So therefore, the conclusion is that so far material comforts are concerned, you cannot get more or less. You will get. It is already fixed. Deho yogena deha. Sukham indriya kang daitya. Deho yogena dehina. Sarvatra labhate. Yathadukham ajatanata. Prahlad Maharaj said. Sarvatra labhate. So far material comfort is concerned, what you are destined to get, you will get it. In wherever you may live, it doesn't matter. Your allotment is already there. That is your body. And our sense pleasure means this material bodily pleasure, that is all. Sukham o indriyakam. We have got these senses, hands, legs, eyes, ears, and five, and working senses, and gathering, knowledge gathering senses. They are all constitute the whole body. So bodily comfort means the sense gratification. Dharma, artha, kama. But here it is said, Trivargikam, sangastha vijnaya sangnasya, karma trivargikam jachat. Well, you are ready for death, there is no more this trivargikam. Trivargikam means religion and economic development and Sanskrit. This is human civilization. This is not human civilization in one sense, because there is question of dharma. Dharma means religion. Religion, not exactly the same way as we understand in English language, a kind of faith, dharma. Generally people understand that I have got my own dharma. I am Hindu, I am Christian, I am Muslim, I am this, I am that. But in Sanskrit language, dharma does not mean like that, a kind of faith. No, faith is blind. Today you are Hindu, tomorrow you are Christian, today you are Christian. So this faith changing is not dharma. Dharma means which you cannot change. That is dharma. Not that whimsically I change. That dharma is service. Every one of us rendering some service to other. That is dharma. Every one of us. Jiver Sarupa Nitya Krishna Das. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gives us immediate information what he is, a living entity. He immediately gives the definition that a living entity means who is rendering service to the Lord. So we are rendering service. Somebody is rendering service to the country, society, family, and at least to dog, to cat. That is our general inclination, because we want to give service to the Supreme, but because we have forgotten the Supreme, our service attitude is now distributed in so many ways. But I am serving, that's a fact. Either you serve dog or either you serve God. This service is there, that you cannot avoid. You cannot say, nobody can say that I am not serving anyone. Even becoming God, so-called God, as there are so many rascals, they say that we are God or I am God, everyone God. God is never servant. God is enjoyer, God is master. God does not serve anyone. Just like you see, we have God here, Krishna. He is not serving, he is enjoying. That is God. He will always find God enjoying. God is not serving, master. Krishna says, bhokta. Bhokta means enjoyer. Everyone should be engaged for his service. And he is the only enjoyer. Ekala Ishwar Krishna. The only enjoyer, only master is Krishna. And all others, they are servants. Now there may be gradation of servants. Just like in your country, President Nixon is also a servant. An ordinary constable, he is also a servant. Everyone is servant. Nobody is master. So there is gradation of service, that's all. Somebody is serving as president, somebody is serving as constable, somebody is serving as dog, somebody is serving as cat, and similarly somebody is loving reciprocally in this way. The whole situation is there. But the central point is master is Krishna, God, and our love should be reposed unto him. This is the point. This is Krishna consciousness. Sadadhana, Mahamana. So one who has fixed up his goal of life in this way, that I am rendering service, that's a fact, but I am not satisfied. Why? I am rendering so much service. Just like in our country, Mahatma Gandhi rendered so much service to his country that at the end he was killed by his countrymen. This is the return. Your country also, President Kennedy, he was a nice president, but he was killed. So here in this material world, or Maya, if you render service to Maya, illusion, you will never be satisfied. Neither the person to whom you are giving service, he will be satisfied. There is no satisfaction either to the so-called master or to the servant, because Krishna is missing, that's all. One should understand this. This is the actually fact. Here the service is going on, but the master and the servant both are not satisfied. But there is another platform, spiritual world, where service rendered, both the master and the servant become satisfied. Immediate. Tasmin tuṣṭe jagat tuṣṭa. The same example. Just like you put your eatables into the stomach, so the stomach is satisfied and all the servants, the hands, legs and others who acquired that foodstuff and put into the mouth, they are also satisfied, automatically. The hands, legs, fingers, eyes, every part of my body immediately satisfied. Yatha prano paharacha jatendriyana. We are at the present moment in the material existence, we are trying to be satisfied. That is also the example is there. There's a child is crying. You give him something eatable, he puts it in the mouth and he's satisfied. No more crying. Similarly, actually if we want to be satisfied, then, as it is said here, saṅsthāṁ vijñāya saṅnasya karma toivadikam. Give up this saṅsthāṁ vijñāya. Saṅsthāṁ means death. Death is your... death is the best surety, as sure as death. Nobody can say that I can avoid death. That's a fact. So, one who actually understands that I'll have to die, people do not understand. Everyone thinks that he will not die. He'll not die. That is called Maya. He's seeing that everyone is dying. Still he is thinking that I shall not die or I shall live for millions of years. There is no question of death. But it is a fact. You may be advanced in science, but death is sure. That's a fact. Therefore it is advised here that saṅsthāṁ vijñāya, one who is actually intelligent, he should know that he will die. But the kurmis, the rascals, he knows also that he will die, at least theoretically accept. But he wants to enjoy, since the death does not come, to the fullest extent. That is the present condition of the society. He knows that he'll die. So long my senses are there, let me gratify. Now yesterday, when I went to the bank, there was a cinema signboard. What is that?
Is there sex after death?
Yeah. You see? Because this material life means sex. So they are seeking sex after death also. This is, a plain acceptance of the materialistic here. Is there sex after death? They are inquiring. If there is sex after death, then they are not fearful of death. There is a story that one man was drinking. So drinking in India is a great sin. So his friend advised that you are drinking, you'll go to hell. So he said, oh, my father also drinks. So he said, your father also will go to hell. Oh, my brother also drinks. Oh, he'll also go to hell. In this way, he continued to say, my father, my brother, my sister, my this, my that. And he was replying, yes, he'll also go to hell. Oh, then hell is heaven. Because we all drinking here and drink there. So what is the hell? That is heaven. Similarly, this signboard is like that. If sex is there after death, then that is not death, that is life. You see? So actually, you have got sex after death. Because you'll get into another body. Now you are having sex as human being in very nice apartment or on the street, on the beach, as you like.
The next life also, as cats and dogs, we will have sex life. The sex life is not denied because the life is there. Ara nidra bhaya maithunancha. This maithun, maithun means sex life. Eating, sleeping, and sex life, and defending. Ahara nidra bhaya maithunancha. Samana metat pasubhina rana. This is now inquiry. Now, if this inquiry is taken scientifically, is there sex after death? It is not joking. If it is taken seriously, so people should be informed that yes, there is sex after death. Why there is no sex? Because there is life after death. You get another body, maybe God's body, demigod's body, or dog's body. You will get another body according to your own work. And as soon as you get body, these four things are there: eating, sleeping, sex, and defending. So there is actually. So the higher inquiry should be that. Then what is the position of the sex life? The position of the sex life is eternal. The sex life is from Radha and Krishna. Chini-mithun. Chini-mithun, spiritual. But there the sex life is not like this. Abominable sex life. There is sex impulse in the origin. Otherwise, how you have got this sex impulse? In the Vedanta Sutra, it is said, janmadasya jatah. Supreme Brahma, absolute truth is there, is that from whom everything comes. So if there is sex life, then in the absolute truth, there must be sex life. Otherwise, where you have got it? Where from we get it? Everything is there. But the difference is that here everything is contaminated, abominable, and there everything is without inebrieties. It is happy, healthy, and eternal, blissful. That is the difference. The things are there. Just like Krishna's motherly affection, of Mother Yashoda upon Krishna. And Krishna is playing as child, pleasing Mother Yashoda. But that thing is also in this material world. Here also, the mother likes to raise his beloved child. The child also plays to give pleasure to the mother. The rasa. Rasa means this humor or mellow. Exchange between the mother and the child is there and here also. Similarly, friendship, similarly, conjugal love, everything, all the five rasas, melos, are there. The impersonalist cannot understand this. They are afraid of, as soon as they hear love, love. Here is love, frustrated, then it is Maya. Then Krishna's love is also Maya. Therefore they are called Mayavadi. They are carrying this material idea to the spiritual idea. And when they cannot accommodate, they make it zero or impersonal. Shunyavadi. That is their position. They cannot understand. These very things are existing in the spiritual world in a blissful way. So there is sex, but that is blissful sex, not that. Here we want to enjoy sex life, but at the same time want to get out of the result of sex life. Therefore we use contraceptive tablets. Because the result of sex life is very, miserable. So we want to avoid the miserable condition of sex life. But there is another life where there is no miserable condition of sex life. That is spiritual life. That the ordinary poor fund of knowledge, they cannot understand it. They think that here the sex life is miserable condition and sex life. So if in the spiritual world there is also sex life, then it is also miserable. So this conception of sex impulse, just like Radha Krishna and gopis dealing with Krishna, they think it is Maya. Therefore they are called Mayavadi. They have no knowledge. Their brain cannot accommodate this idea that all these activities can be very blissful, supreme, without any difficulty, without any miserable condition. They cannot understand it. But therefore, it requires higher intelligence to understand Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness is trying to give the people the happiness which is simply blissful without any inabilities. That is Krishna consciousness. So here, Vasudeva Bhagavati Atma Bhavam Dirangata. Vasudeva Bhagavati. Vasudev, the son of Vasudev, Krishna Bhagavati, he is the Supreme Personality of God. Here, just like if I give one's father's name, then you know the man particularly. So here, Bhagavati, there are many expansions of God. Advaita Achyuta Anadi Ananta Rupam. But he is particularly mentioned here. Vasudev, Krishna. Krishna's name is Vasudev. Vasudeva Bhagavati Atma Bhavam Dirangata. We are trying to enjoy life by making friends, Atma Bhavam. Atma Bhavam means very intimate, near relative or beloved. So we have to change our consciousness. Instead of trying to make this material world as beloved, you have to make Krishna as beloved. That is Krishna consciousness. Everything is there. You get everything in return as you're trying to enjoy, but without any inability. That is called Krishna consciousness. So, Parikshit Maharaj attained this stage. Therefore, he could give up all his kingdom, all his family, all his animal and everything, and he simply became Krishna conscious. What is the purpose?
Three activities of religion, economic development, and sense gratification.
Oh, there is no time. All right, happy. Pray.